Our first performer is a jack-off. All trades. He cooks, he plays music, he does improv, he shoots videos, music videos, only for the ladies of the cohort. Please welcome our resident Tahir Shah, Roro.
Welcome to Khemka Auditorium. Please wear your masks and maintain social distancing at all times.
So today, the stand-up comedy club promised you a night of fun and laughter, but I've decided to do something different. Something that you haven't had at ISB before. An in-person lecture. In Khemka. With an international speaker. And the topic I'll be discussing today is India. Now I know what you're thinking. Ye to bahar ka aadmi hai. Ye humko kya sikhayega? Which is also what the client will say when the consultant shows up at their office. So anyway, before coming to ISB, I was clueless about India. I was so clueless that I didn't know 95% of our memes were based on three movies. Hera Feri, Welcome. Anyone want to guess the third one? Fir Hera Feri. I was so clueless about India that I didn't realize alcohol delivery was illegal until I got into an argument about it on Telegram. At 3 a.m. In my defense, how was I supposed to know that a secular democracy would have more restrictive alcohol laws than a Muslim dictatorship? And lastly, I was so clueless about India, I submitted an assignment where I wrote that the solution to affordable housing in Dharavi was to turn it into a casino. Can you guess how much I scored on this assignment out of 20?
Zero!
I got 19 out of 20! You can tell why I got placed in a real estate firm. So jokes aside, I did learn some real things at ISB. The first thing I learned was during trigger warning, placement prep. I was watching a video series by two guys from trigger warning, BCG. And they were talking about market sizing. And it was the same freaking thing every single time. You start off with the population of India, 1.39 billion. My God, for a nation that is scared to talk about sex, we are surely having a lot of it. Even if the aftermath of the Yule Ball suggests otherwise. So they start off with the population, and they divide it into 30% urban and 70% rural. Rural logo ko goli marke, they focus on the urban residents. Next, they sort for income. And they have a heuristic. Wow, kya shabd hai, heuristic. 10% are rich. Aur baki sab bhaad mein jaate. So 30 million is actually a large number. It's more than the population of the Netherlands, Australia, and Canada. I told you this would be educational. So the top 10% of Indians have 77% of the wealth. And I can sum up our lifestyle in one sentence. We spend our money to go to places in India to stand there and say, "Are, ye to India jaise nahi lagta hai." Whether it's this beach in Goa, this brewery called Broadway, or this campus called ISB. My favorite was this restaurant called Hole in the Wall. In the US, a hole in the wall is a small, dingy bar, shop, or restaurant. Clearly, these people didn't get the memo. Also, who the f*** is naming these restaurants? Hole in the wall, TK. Ek aur jagah dekha, glass onion. Agar tera pyaaz glass se banta hai, to mere ko nahi khana hai. Fir ek aur jagah dekha, fat pigeon. To bolna kya chahte ho? अरे किसको खाना खिला रहा है? मेरे को या कबूतर को? Fat pigeon, कुछ भी हो रहा है. It's like they are running an improv show where they ask the audience for suggestions. Remember improv? So quickly, can I get a suggestion from the audience? Can I get an adjective?
Gassy.
Cool, can I get a noun?
Booga.
Okay, Ivy, thank you. Okay guys, screw placements. I'm inviting you all to my restaurant called Gassy Booger. So coming back to India, while the 10% may have all the wealth, we only have 10% of the voting rights. So can I get a quick cheer from all of you? How many of you voted in the last national election? How many of you voted in the last state assembly election? And how many of you voted in the last municipal election? Guys, give them a round of applause. For those of you wondering what a municipal election is, it's where you vote for the people that actually do the work. But true confession, I've never voted before. Kyunki main bahar tha na. Aur bahar se voting allowed nahi hai. Which is surprising. You think Modi would legalize international voting, given how much time he spent campaigning outside the country? So anyway, what I learned from this is that the government really doesn't care about us, which is why our needs are served by the private sector. So when we think of food, we think of Big Basket, Zomato, and Swiggy. When we want clothes, we think of Myntra, H&M, and my personal favorite fashion, Big Bazaar. When we want a place to stay, we think of DLF, Loda, and SV4. And you pass Godo ECI. When we want healthcare, we go to Continental. When we want transport, we think of Uber. When we want clean drinking water, we think of Hema Malini. Because, and say this with me, Kent deta hai? So guys, the truth is, I'm barely scratching the surface of what India is. When you live abroad, you hear that India is slow, crowded, dirty, old-fashioned, and divided. But when you come here, you realize that India is also fast, beautiful, clean, modern, and diverse. If you're rich.